Yes, dear students, let us grab some of the knowledge, right? In the previous class, the very first class, we were talking about some flowers, and then in between, I also gave you a PDF file, right? About the farming condition, the different type of cropping pattern that we have in our country, which is mainly related to your next chapter, that is page number 5. Today, let us see some of the, you know, things related to nature, which is termed as lungs of the earth. Lungs in a human body, that's the main, one of the main organ, you know, because of which we breathe in nowadays, especially this what you call corona, COVID. As per the news channels and as per the doctors' advices, you know, it is when this particular virus, they enter into the lungs, that is the last stage when a person is unable to survive. So how important is lungs? That is the main area, the main breathing portion. Let's see what this chapter has to offer us. Lungs, why it is termed as the lungs of the earth. Rainforests are mostly found in the tropical and subtropical zones of the world. These are huge, dense jungles which receive a very high amount of rainfall. Rainforests are characterized by the dense canopies that make for dimly lit days and pitch dark nights. Alright, so basically this is about the forest, the different type of rainforests that we have, right, that the world has, or you know, the speciality about the rainforest, the different type of wildlife, flora and fauna, or animals which are being found out there, plants, trees, forests, nature. But we don't need forests, we need big buildings. We need shopping complex, and we think that is development, right? Forest, jungle, who will go to forest, jungle? And now see, we don't need forest, we need buildings, we need shopping complex, we need this, that, malls and all, and as a result we are unable to breathe, lack of oxygen. Why don't you get that oxygen from that shopping malls, buildings, bridges, roads and all? Those are a very necessary part of life. It is required. I'm not saying that those are not required or I stay in jungle. No. We all need it. But at the same time, why can't we, like, if we, for, in order to construct a road or a house, if we have to chop down or, you know, cut down 10 trees, why can't we plant 100 trees somewhere else? Now, why am I saying that you have cut down 10 trees, but I'm asking you to plant 100 trees? Because those 10 trees are grown up. And if you plant another 10 trees, it will take some time for it to grow up. So as a result, to maintain the ratio of balance, plant 100 trees. I'm not saying plant 100 trees in the middle of the road or somewhere in someone's house. There are places, go to you know, places where there is no construction, where still there are so many protected areas, you know, reserved forests. Go there, plant it. But no, we don't have time. We have time only to cut down the trees, make our own houses. Why do you think about so much? When we are surviving, let us survive. Why to worry about others and the society, right? That is our mentality. And later on what happens is that when we fall into the trouble, then we think, oh, how nice it would have been if we would have done this or that. So go through this. There are some puzzle words given, okay? And also you have on that particular image, if you see on the right hand side, find out the names of two birds found in the Amazon rainforest, two reptiles found in the rainforest of Asia, two mammals which live in the rainforest of Africa. You know, animals or birds or plants or whatever, you know, they play a very important role for us. They help us to survive. Now, the way how they help us to survive is that maintaining the ecological balance. There's a movie. I forgot the name of the movie, okay? Nothing to do with the name. Just let me come to the concept. In that particular movie, what happens is that birds, right, because of this various development, we call it as a development, but I say it is not development, because development is one, you know, just progressing or acquiring more things, achieving, that is not development. In fact, development means some progress of yours, which is not hampering someone else's progress, or which is not hampering the nature, I would say that. A progress of yours which doesn't affect the nature and also which doesn't affect the future, okay, the future generation. That's called a development. just because just you are growing, but whereas you the nature is not growing and someone else life is affected or the future is getting affected, that isn't a development. But who has got time to think so much, right? This human being, we nowadays, we people, yes, we are human being, but we are not being human. We don't have humanity. That is the main problem with us. And all the problem that arises in the society is because of this one simple term. You just think about it, class 8 students, right? We are so selfish, we are all worried about our own self. We think that, you know, this world belongs to us. Oh, I'm the boss, I'm the master of this world, everything is mine. Look at this lungs of the earth. We are worried about our lungs, we are not worried about the lungs of the earth. And see, the earth is giving us now with interest that you are bothered about your lungs, not mine. Now pay for it. And we are paying for it. And that is the reason you are sitting at your home now. I am sitting out here, right? Because of this, we are not worried about the lungs of earth. We are not able to meet one another physically. You're missing your school, your friends. You miss me, right? I know my students love me a lot. Anyway, coming back to your text. Even though you don't love me, but I love my students, huh? Alright, so complete up this exercise that is being mentioned out here. And at the same time, let me tell you, the answers of which are also mentioned at the end of the text, which you may be very well aware of. If you flip the pages and see the answers and write down without making it function, you will be at loss, not me. See, today's world, we say GK, general knowledge, what to do, this is not one of the main subjects, my dear. These are the main subjects. Without knowledge, you're not going to achieve anything, nothing. One who has knowledge, nobody can stop that particular person from achieving his or her goal, come what may. The thing is, the more and more you acquire knowledge, you know, the more you are leading to the path of success. So don't try to cheat yourself. And if you try to cheat yourself, it's you who will be in loss. I can guide you. I cannot force you. You guys are grown up kids, right? All right. So we'll see in the next class. Please go through it. It's interesting. Do some, you know, brainstorming, correct? And you will see, you will like it. And even there are many more things which you will get to know, something which you were, like, even don't, you know, at times it happens with me. I won't say about other teachers, but at times it happens with me. I being a teacher does not mean that I'm God and I know everything. No, even in the process of teaching, it so happens that I do learn many things. That is what teaching is. Teaching is basically what? It is learning and then making someone else learn. That is called teaching. That's my definition of teaching. So even I would want each one of you to do that as well. Try to learn, enhance your knowledge. Okay? See you in the next class, guys. Be home, be safe, study well.